Man, in this hip hop game, we've got a couple of juggernauts, a couple of front runners, people that really help pave the way for everyone else to kind of come. And I think Dame is literally probably one of the most, I'd say, disrespected, underrated, underappreciated hip hop figures. This guy single-handedly has made this whole entrepreneurial landscape that, like, everyone, I see everyone kind of adopting in the current day. This whole kind of get out of the 9-to-5 mindset. That Breakfast Club interview in its own was probably one of the most classic interviews ever. So what I'm doing today, I'm breaking down three clips of him that kind of explain how he kind of got to his success. I think overall he gets quite a bad rap. Like, I think because people see him in that Breakfast interview and he was going kind of crazy, his delivery was a bit questionable. But when I show you these other clips and you see him when he's talking, when he's calm, I think it will be a lot easier to kind of break down those messages, and it'll be easier to kind of accept and understand where he's trying to take us, because this man is truly a genius. All right, the tone of this first bit is going to be a bit somber. So we got Dame kind of talking about how the death of his mom shaped him, and she kind of taught him that he needs to make things happen and just make sure he's never stagnant, never passive. If he's got a problem, he needs to speak up.
And I was just always able to put myself in a better place. I never let anybody else control my destiny. My mom's taught me to make things happen on my own, not to depend on anybody, and if I have an opinion, to speak on it.
So you were there.
I think that first clip talking about making things happen, I think that is, when it comes to Dame Dash, the root of him is kind of that mindset. I think instead of kind of doing the status quo, doing what's normally done, you kind of have to make something out of nothing. He said that his mom kind of taught him that, and I completely agree with it. If things aren't maybe going the way how you want them to happen, I think if things are going stagnant, you need to think of a way to kind of make things happen. I mean, even if you look at his career, even before 1996 Rockefeller, he was with the Best Out crew. They were throwing parties. And even with Rockefeller, when Jay-Z got denied from all of those record labels, instead of kind of sitting down and feeling like, oh no, we didn't get the major deal, all three of them, him, Jay, and Biggs, they managed to make things happen, and they managed to get an independent record label. And that was just through thinking outside the box. So I think making things happen at the root of it is one of Dame Dash's best skills, and I'm 100% sure that has definitely propelled him to where he's at now. Okay, so we got this clip of Dame talking about how if you want to last 5 to 10 years at least in a game, have to be consistent.
As a professional, the only way to be a professional is to work harder than everybody. A professional, like a professional baseball player, a boxer, is someone that's better than everyone else. That's why he gets paid so much to do it. That means work. It ain't nothing professional going to get given to you. There's some sacrifice. There's always pain. And, you know, it's always going to be dark times because that's part of business. Every time you create a new business, you got to struggle a little bit. And it takes a while to build a brand. It takes about 5 years to be consistent. Like my first 5 years, you know, I'm not saying nothing different. I've been saying the same exact stuff. If you go look at backstage and any kind of argument I had, it's always been consistent. It's just people weren't ready for it. They didn't trust it. But after I've been saying it for 10 years or five, you know, 5 to 10, now it's a brand. I have a brand for it. I'm consistent. I back it up. I'm still here. I'm still up. Even when, you know, being an independent meant looking like you was down.
Consistency, consistency, consistency. After all of the years, hours, months, however long, after all this time I've spent watching interviews from not even people in hip hop, just famous people in general, consistency is definitely the one thing I think that's probably the most common thing that I notice with all these millionaires and billionaires. And Dame said it right there. You need at least 5 years of consistency. I'm going to have to pause for that one. I know that's going to be a huge shock to people, but 5 years. And this is Dame telling you this. This guy has been consistent for 25 years now. From 1996 to 2021, this guy is still here. He's still consistent. According to him, he's got more money now than he did back then when we all thought he was popular and he was popping. So clearly that consistency of he said minimum 5 years, even 10 years, just putting in that work at a high level as well. The more consistent you are, the better you get at your craft, the more you kind of own in your craft, you can actually branch out to other areas, just as Dame has done, from music to Rockaware clothing to art, working with the Black Keys, Dame Dash Studios, everything. So we can see the consistency is clearly part of his brand. Yeah, so we got this clip of Dame talking about how during nursery he was embarrassed by the teacher, and that feeling was so horrible for him that he wanted to just make sure that he's never in that position again. So he kind of, if anything, he kind of lent more into that embarrassment, and he wanted to be the outcast. He didn't want to be the same as everyone else. And from that, he knew that if he wasn't the same as everyone else, that means that he's doing something special. So he kind of breaks that down in this clip.
Nice. So, you know, so at a young age, I remember getting yelled at in nursery school, like I was 4 or 5, and I felt this feeling of embarrassment. And at that moment, I was able to identify that feeling. And I was like, I will never let myself feel embarrassed again. So from then on, nothing.
At that young an age.
Yeah. I would just, you know, I didn't like the feeling. Like, I felt funny. I felt like I was shrinking. Like, you know, when Fred Flintstone gets yelled at and you get smaller.
Yeah.
I didn't like anybody making me feel smaller just by the energy of their voice. So it was almost like I put this repellent on where nothing could embarrass me. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. I just never really cared. And I never wanted to be a part of a crowd. I always wanted to be an individual. I hated when everybody looked the same. So it was like, it was corny to me to like something because somebody else liked it. So I was like that guy that was like, if you like it, I'm not gonna like it. You know, I always wanted to be first, never be last. I never wanted to like follow a trend. I've always wanted to start it. And I think that comes from the Harlem swag and all that. And that confidence is what made me not really care. So when I would speak about things that no one else was speaking about, or if I was gonna do something that no one else did, I embraced that loneliness, you know, because it meant I was doing something right where other people
weren't scared of standing right out there on your
and
own.
And as a result of it, because I would always give 100 fearlessly and stand behind my point of view, I always got the reception that I thought that I deserved, which was, you know, being able to have the life that I wanted.
Well, that's kind of interesting as well that you were.
Man, in my lifetime, I've seen a few video clips of some of my so-called idols, and they're showing some elite level of thinking, some higher level kind of stuff. And I think the fact that Dame can even use this analogy from nursery, the way that he's talking about, he didn't want to feel embarrassed, so he put on a repellent. Like, to me, that is such a next level of thinking. That is amazing, the way that he realized that he didn't want to look be the same as everyone else. He wanted to stand out from the crowd. The fact that he was able to link the fact that standing out from the crowd meant that he was doing something that was actually revolutionary and good. And if you think about that, that's got great parallels to his career. Think about his career, the fact that he tried to take Jay-Z to all of the labels, everyone was on a major, Rockefeller went independent, he was doing something different, so then he realized that what he was doing was right, and then 5 years later, everyone starts copying him. That fearlessness, that kind of, that tunnel vision to not care about other people's opinions, and not let yourself get embarrassed again. I think it's amazing. I think the fact that he can kind of, I think it's a mix of fearlessness and it's a mix of just not really caring what other people think, knowing that him being on his own, embracing that loneliness is actually positive, and within time, eventually people will actually see that what he's doing is the way forward.